soldiers stationed here were the 35th Regiment of Foot. 35th Regiment of Foot from Great Britain was made up of convicted criminals who were taken from the prisons. King George needed men to fight the French. He was running low because nobody wanted to come over here and fight. This was a godforsaken place. The closest civilization is 16 miles south, and from Fort Edward, the closest civilization is another 60 miles south. So if you were a common criminal in jail, the king made a proclamation that if you would come to the colonies, join the army, and fight the French for 1 year, that you would be pardoned. You would then have 5 more years to spend in the army, but after that time, you were considered a free man. So the soldiers were here, 35th Regiment of Foot. We didn't like them, they didn't like us. A soldier of the 35th is paid 8 cents a day, the crown takes 6, leaving them with 2. That's where you get your 2 cents worth, because they needed to have their food and their uniforms. I make 30 cents a day because I supply all of my own equipment. I supply my own clothes, my own food, my own musket. Just that simple. What made us equal per se is this device. This is a 75 caliber Brown Bess musket. Called a Brown Bess musket because it's brown. And Bess is a popular woman's name at this time in history. The musket was actually came into existence during the reign of Queen Anne. It's a smoothbore gun, 75 caliber with a .810 inch diameter bore, which means the ball is a much smaller diameter than the bore to facilitate loading. You can load and fire this musket 3 times a minute. The musket ball being 75 caliber at 3/4 inch in diameter will punch a hole in you the size of your thumb and exit the size of your fist. At 25 yards, you're dead. 50 yards, you might get up. 75 yards, you will get up. 100 yards, you can stand there all day long and nobody's gonna hit you. Maximum range on this musket is 500 yards. But because of the smaller ball, one went high, one went low. Where the hell did the other one go? Because we don't know. Just that simple. Right now, if I pull it one time, it'll click. That's called half cock. If I pull the trigger, nothing happens, and I try it again, nothing happens, and I start to look down the bore, hopefully it's not going to go off half-cocked. If it does, we have severe problems. A British soldier was responsible for his musket. Boat's leaving in 5 minutes. British soldier responsible for his musket, lock, stock, and barrel. That he was. If a soldier lost his musket, he had to pay for it at 2 cents a day. It took him about 18 months. That's the way it was, just that simple. To be a soldier in the British Army, you had to have 2 good teeth, one up and one down, opposing each other so you could tear open your cartridge. It was a paper cartridge with a 75 caliber ball and 85 grains of black powder tied with a string. You would take your 2 opposing teeth, tear open a cartridge, prime the pan, close the pan, cast about, take the rest of the cartridge, put it down inside the bore, ram down. As I said earlier, 3 shots a minute. Black powder has 3 ingredients, charcoal, sulfur, and saltpeter. If you put black powder into a saucer and light it, it will spark, spin, and smoke, and do nothing else. But if you compress it, it will explode, forcing the ball out the end of the muzzle, 900 feet per second, or 636 miles an hour. So I primed the pan, closed the pan, cast about, poured the powder down inside, I usually take and make 3 shots a minute. They don't allow us to shoot bullets anymore. We have to shoot these things called fiber wads. That's why British soldiers are called regulars, because they get their fiber every day. The 3 commands to fire the musket: make ready, present, give fire. Tends to do that. I have to fix them. Hand on my my powder, which is bad. Three commands, make ready, present, give fire. Do I have a young person who would like to give me commands? Young person who would like to give me commands? Has a loud outside voice? I guess not. It's okay. You tell me. Make ready.
Make ready.
Present.
Present.
Get fine.
Get fine.
That was the girl.
Oh.
Delayed
the
action.
All right. Have a great day. Give her a big applause. So, the command, present. A British soldier was not allowed to aim at his adversary. If he was aiming at his adversary, he could be brought up on murder charges and hanged. It's a gentleman's war. 5,000 British, 5,000 French, 25 yards apart. Everybody lowers the musket to chest high, parallel. Everybody smiles. And everybody pulls a trigger. You're bound to hit something. That you are. So why do British soldiers have red uniforms? So you can see them through the smoke. On a very hot day with no wind, we have what's called fog of war. The black powder smoke will hang about 3 feet off the ground and be about 10 to 12 feet above you. You can see the red uniforms in the smoke, but you can't see the French uniforms, which are white or blue. So you just fire into the smoke. And the British soldiers, after they fired three volleys, will fix bayonets and charge through the smoke at their enemy. A little bit of historical information. Average size French soldier this time in history was 4 feet 10. Average size British soldier was 5 feet 4. Why were the uniforms red? Because King George has the largest army, largest navy in the world. And because of this, he wants everybody to know who he is, so he will give them red uniforms. The uniforms are dyed with madder red dye, M-A-D-D-E-R, which is the most expensive dye to be had this time in history. This way, he says, when we're trouncing you and beating you into submission, you will know who we are. One other friendly little tidbit. George II will die of constipation. 6 weeks bound up before he succumbs to the heart attack. Why? Because of opioid poisoning. It was back then, folks. You never know.